Hi, my name is Emma and I'm the Chief Scientist at Izon Science, and today I'll be guiding you through the fundamentals of Tunable Resistive Pulse Sensing, or TRPS for short. TRPS is used for single particle analysis in the micro and nanometer size range, and can be used to analyse the size distribution, concentration and zeta potential of a sample population. Your sample must be able to be suspended in an electrolyte solution. TRPS technology uses the quarter principle on a nanoscale. A voltage is applied across the nanopore via silver-silver chloride electrodes in the fluid cell. The ions in the electrolyte solution start to migrate according to their charge in the electric field and create a stable current. We call it baseline current. The instrument records this current at a high sample rate. Particles in the sample are driven through the nanopore by a combination of electrokinetic and hydrodynamic transport mechanisms. When a particle passes through the nanopore, conductive solution gets displaced and the resistance of the pore increases. This increase of resistance or decrease in current is detected as a transient pulse by the instrument. The TRPS technique is capable of measuring the size, charge and concentration of the particles, as these properties are linked to the magnitude, duration and frequency of the current pulses. The decrease in current is known as a blockade event. The magnitude of the blockade relative to the baseline is proportional to the volume of the particle, as a larger particle displaces more electrolyte solution. The amount of time it takes the particle to traverse the nanopore is called blockade duration, and indicates how fast the particle moved through the nanopore. This time can be related to the charge of the particle. And finally, the number of blockades that occur per unit time is proportional to the concentration of particles in the solution. The tunable parameters of TRPS are the stretch of the nanopore, the voltage, and the pressure. The stretch controls the size of the nanopore. It determines the dynamic range of the nanopore, which means which size range of particles can be measured at a certain stretch. Increasing the stretch makes the nanopore larger, and the relative blockade size of particles smaller. The stretch also determines the baseline current, as increasing the stretch increases the baseline, as more ions can flow through the pore. The applied voltage also determines the baseline current. A higher voltage increases the baseline proportionally. For the same size particle, the relative change in current remains unchanged. However, the absolute blockade magnitude increases. This is advantageous for the signal-to-noise ratio. The applied pressure affects how fast a particle travels through the nanopore. A higher pressure will increase the hydrodynamic flow through the pore and therefore decreases the duration of the blockade. For example, the applied pressure can be used to balance the electrokinetic transport mechanisms to allow for a high precision charge measurement. A multi-pressure measurement, on the other hand, is used for an accurate concentration measurement. The three parameters, stretch, voltage, and pressure, are key to making TRPS one of the most powerful single particle solution-based measurement techniques. In the next video, we will go over the three forces at play inside the nanopore. As always, please contact us at support@izon.com if you have any questions. Thank you.